There's a proposal that wants $25 million from the Compound Treasury. Obviously, nobody will vote for it. The vote passes. Compound has just been governance attacked right in front of their own eyes. And this could have easily been stopped. Had the blockchain club at UCLA or Columbia or any of these voted, this would have never happened. But hey, don't blame the kids. I would choose showing up for my summer internship rather than stopping an attack where I have no skin in the game with these votes some VC only gave me because it's legally risky for them to vote themselves. On the other side is a single entity, and this isn't his first rodeo. He famously started the Balancer Wars in 2022. He also acquired so much sushi, it forced the team to siphon out the treasury in fear he would steal it first. And now, after this proposal, Humpy nearly doubled his voting power, controlling more votes than the next 8 combined. Compound is one of the largest DeFi protocols. If he already got this proposal passed, just imagine what he could do now. Humpy is a veteran DeFi whale with his own meme coin, Golden Boys. It's also a farm token you can earn for free. For example, deposit comp into this vault, which delegates your votes to Humpy. In return, you can stake this to earn gold. Finally, you can always withdraw your original comp. Essentially, Humpy is bribing you for your voting power. At first, Humpy proposed moving 5% of the compound treasury to this farm so they could earn some yield on their idle tokens. How nice of him, right? Besides the obvious concerns of putting the treasury in some weird yield farm, this proposal poses a clear security risk. Nothing stops Humpy's multisig from flat-out stealing the tokens. At the same time, a security researcher points to suspicious behavior he noticed a week ago. These addresses withdrew large amounts of comp from Bybit in the same pattern. These are Humpy's secret wallets, and he wants to hide his votes so people don't suspect an attack. Humpy insists that the multisig is made up of trusted individuals and that the code is audited, but he concedes and cancels the proposal. Ultimately, he just doesn't have enough votes, so he continues buying more comp on secret wallets. This time, he mixes in organic activity to make it look less suspicious. And notice how he never withdraws more than 25,000 to a single wallet. This is exactly the threshold needed to propose a vote, and if a wallet exceeds that, it alerts the Discord. He already got caught once, but it looks like nobody notices this time. He comes back with a new proposal. It now uses a smart contract that guarantees the tokens can only be used for generating yield and nothing else. Still, Wintermute points out Humpy's team has complete control over any withdrawal actions, meaning the DAO can't recall funds on its own. And remember that the comp deposited into this strategy gets delegated to Humpy. It looks more like a ploy for Humpy to boost his already massive voting power. The security researcher continues to warn everyone. As mentioned previously, he thinks Humpy secretly controls these votes, but he's unaware of the new wallets that would push the vote to here. Humpy has enough votes to make the proposal pass, but he doesn't pull the trigger. $5 million isn't enough for him. He's too greedy. The vote fails. Humpy continues buying more comp and makes his final move. He already knows he can win, so he copies his last proposal exactly and asks for 5 times as many tokens. $25 million. Something is wrong. This is an attack. 30 minutes before voting ends, the secret wallets start voting, and it's gonna pass. But wait, UPenn's blockchain club hasn't voted yet. A student told me that he thought someone else already voted, but the compound delegates group chat prompted him to double check their vote. Literally 1 minute before the deadline, he steps in, but it's not enough. DeFi governance feels broken. In principle, governance tokens are distributed to the community through things like airdrops and liquidity mining. These give powers to the actual users of the protocol. However, the vast majority of users sell their tokens, and the power consolidates into the hands of a few buyers. It's like if every American citizen was airdropped a vote token. Would you cast your vote knowing it has virtually zero chance of influencing the outcome, or sell it for $100? The financialization of DeFi votes means they often end up controlled by a small, powerful minority. So what are Humpy's motivations? Why did he buy so many votes, and what does he want out of it? At first, you might think he intends to use this to flat out steal from the treasury, but I don't think this is actually the case. From his perspective, he's only using game theory to make money. Last time he did this during the Balancer Wars, he used his tokens to vote for pools he had a majority stake in, which let him farm even more tokens. This was a calculated play, but one within the rules of the game. He simply used his outsized voting power to create an outsized benefit for himself. It's also worth noting that there's a time lock before a vote can be executed, which allows people to react to malicious attacks. And remember that Humpy is a huge holder of Comp, so it's unlikely he plans to do anything too drastic which could destroy the price. This proposal actually makes sense within this framework. Steal funds is a misleading phrase. He is providing yield to the compound treasury in a way that also happens to benefit himself. On that note, I'd like to thank all the holders who voted for our proposal. Regardless of his justification, the community did not take this lightly. They started a new proposal to manually take over. The time lock helps in their case. While Humpy's proposal already passed, this time lock means his newly claimed votes cannot influence the outcome of this particular vote. Given this, and the fact that everyone was paying attention now, it would be easy to get this passed. Following this, they could either blacklist these votes, or more aggressively, all the votes that voted for the proposal. In the end, they negotiate a deal. Humpy cancels his proposal in exchange for a new proposal that allows Comp to be staked to earn 30% of the protocol revenue. For the first time ever, Comp is now a yield-bearing token. The price skyrockets.